The Forumla Data Reference allows you to complete simple calculations, which will not be saved to PyTags. When the time context of PySystem Explorer is set to now, as is by default, the formulas represent the current value, and when used in PyVision displays, they're calculated for the end time of the display. They can even be used to create trends in PyVision. Let's go through a few simple examples. The first is calculating the difference between our current oil temperature and our target oil temperature, both of which are attributes that we've already built. In the second example, let's calculate the time since maintenance has been completed on a pump. Let's get started on our first example, calculating the difference between two attribute values. Let's go and hop on to PySystem Explorer, and here we're at line one in our inlet pump, and taking a look at our attributes, here's our oil temperature, 234 degrees Fahrenheit, and we have a target oil temperature of 201, which is a table lookup based on our pump flow rate, and that's an interpolated value from the table. For our formula calculation, we just want to take the difference between these two values. There's no reason to store it as a Pi point to save its history, so we're going to go ahead and create a new attribute that takes the difference between these two. We'll go to the library, since the pump is made from the pump template, and I'm going to create it as a child attribute just for convenience here. Let me do my oil temperature difference. And I'm going to assign it as a data reference type of formula, and it is value type double. I'll click settings to configure the formula data reference. On the left pane here, we have the parameters. These are your incoming variables. Let me click the star to define my first one. I'll just choose variable A, and that'll be my target oil temperature. It has default units of degrees Fahrenheit, and we want to use Fahrenheit in our calculation, so I'm just going to explicitly state Fahrenheit here. And let me do the same thing for a new variable B, and this will be the current oil temperature based on the Pi Point data reference, and same thing for the temperature here. Now I actually want to take the absolute value of the difference, and let me create an output here, or one of our equations that outputs a result. And here are some of the shortcuts. We can bring in our variables, various operators, functions, and in this case, we're gonna use absolute value, which is here. And then we have a substitution parameter for the current time, which we're actually gonna use in the next example. So for functions, let me go ahead and bring in absolute value. And I'm gonna do A minus B. It doesn't really matter if it's A minus B, B minus A, because we're gonna take the absolute value. Now the output of this equation is going to be in degrees Fahrenheit difference, which is slightly different than just degrees Fahrenheit. So let's see if we can find that here in the list. And here it is, delta degrees Fahrenheit. Let me go ahead and click OK. And one more thing, we said that the output of the formula data reference is delta degrees Fahrenheit, but we also want to make sure that that's displayed by our client. And we can do that by clicking here on our default unit of measure, doing temperature delta, delta degrees Fahrenheit. Let's go back to our element and refresh just to make sure we have the most recent data for both oil temperature and target oil temperature. And then the calculated difference here is 33 degrees Fahrenheit as a difference between two different temperatures. Let's go ahead and work on our second example. And this is to calculate the time since pump maintenance has been completed. If we go back here, we have an attribute called the last repair date. This is actually done as a table lookup. And in the table, which I'm going to take a look at in the library, I just have one simple value here based on the serial number. This is actually the repair date and time. And there is explicitly stated a time zone. So what AF is going to do is this last repair date is actually going to be in the current time zone of my client machine. So if I can take a difference between the current time on my client and this repair date, since this time is already corrected for my client, that'll tell me the time since last repair. Let me go ahead and right click. And again, because it's a template, we're gonna have to go into the library instead. Let me go back to pump template. I'm gonna right click, I'm gonna create a new child attribute. And I'm gonna say days since last repair. My data reference is again going to be formula, and I'll click on settings. The only variable I need to bring in this case is going to be the last repair date, and there's no unit of measure. The equation I need is to take the difference between now and the last repair date. So the substitution parameter is going to be percent time percent. That's the current time on this client machine, wherever this is evaluated. And remember, this isn't actually stored anywhere. It's evaluated locally on each client machine. And then the last repair date. Now, I know that this is going to actually have an output in seconds, so I'm going to make sure that I explicitly state that this is done in seconds. And let me click OK. Now, I want my result to actually be in days. So for the default unit of measure for what I want it displayed as, I'm going to say days. So because I said the output was in seconds, but my default unit of measure is days, it's going to do that conversion for me. And if I go back to elements, and here's the last repair date, and if I open this up, it's been 194 days since my last repair. And again, the conversion from seconds to days is done because I explicitly stated that this output was in seconds, because that's the way that this formula works here. And then by putting days here, it does the conversion for me. And we've looked at two different simple examples for formula data references where you don't need the history of the calculation saved and instead it's done locally on your client. The first is calculating the difference between two attribute values. And the second is doing a simple time calculation, calculating the difference between the current time and the time saved in an attribute.